YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram. What are you doing? It's your boy King Kane, aka the Fit Pharaoh, coming at you with a video. Hey guys, so look, if you haven't seen my $100 burger challenge at Five Guys, be sure to go and look at that video because it is definitely a banger. What happened is we ate a whole bunch of burgers, me and my boys, and we ate basically over 40,000 calories worth of burgers and fries. So we definitely have to put in work. I'm in the gym now doing that at this very moment, besides talking on the camera. Anyway, guys, today is gonna be a leg and, you know what, a shoulder day. Two major muscles, one video, double banger. I'm a little delusional right now because, you know, I just got finished doing some cardio and warming up my body so I can start lifting and get it into the workout. So without further ado, no more talking from the guy in the camera. A voice over me will probably take over sooner or later, but let's get into this workout. Thank you for the introduction, King Kane. Anyway, let's get into this workout, man. Starting off, we're gonna do some shoulder flies, guys. Everything I'm doing is 5 sets of 20 or more. 9 times out of 10, you don't need to do that much, but for me, I got goals and I got a restart and I got a regrowth program I'm trying to work on, so this is what I'm doing to get activated. Again, it's just 5 sets of 20. It is a lot of sets and reps, but hey, you know, you gotta do what you gotta do, guys. Next thing we getting into is leg extensions. Guys, I've been doing legs for like 4 weeks now, and I can honestly say I've made some good growth in it. It's not like super muscular, but I can definitely tell the indentions and insertions of muscles that's actually being activated.
Smash the like button. It's good for you.
You heard him, smash that like button, guys. Anyway, so back into it, guys. Like I was saying, I've been only doing it 4 weeks now, working on my legs once a day. Like I said before, the muscle insertions are definitely there now, so I'm actually surprised at how much my legs have really grown since I first started. Like, I could see no muscles at first, but, you know, like I said, after 4 weeks, you can really definitely see the muscle insertions as soon as I flex my muscle. So, guys, this is a great machine. Definitely use it in your repertoire. It won't do you wrong as long as you do it right. Also, guys, make sure you don't hyperextend when you're using this machine because you really can't hurt yourself. By doing that, I mean, don't overflex it coming up. You know, nice jerk, nice power when using it, but don't overextend, you know. That wouldn't be a good thing. Sorry about this shot, guys. I was trying to get, you know, creative with the Casey Neistat kind of shot. But anyway, so we're getting over to the shoulder flies now. I mean, shoulder press, sorry. Like I said, guys, the double banger, I'm trying to do two major muscles at one time, in one workout. I don't really recommend doing two major muscles. But anyway, like I said, 5 sets of 20, that's what we're doing, guys. When doing this, I mean, some people like to have their back flat against it. I would say have a little arch in your back. I'm not doing too much heavy weight. I think I'm only pressing 90 pounds right now, but I'm trying to get high reps in, so nothing too heavy. All right, guys, now we get into the legs again. This whole workout was mainly focused for my legs, more so than my shoulders. I'm starting off with a good warm-up set, which is, again, 5 sets of 20. That might be a little bit more than a warm-up set for most people. But, you know, for me, it's a nice little warm-up set. I'm trying to, like I said, guys, I'm trying to reactivate these muscles so they can start growing and being used properly. So I like the Smith machine mainly because it helps you with posture, especially for guys who are much taller or, you know, have bad habits of lifting their heels off the ground. When you're on the Smith machine squatting, you do want your feet shoulder length apart, but you also want your feet a little bit more in front of you than right underneath you, guys. This is going to help you with posture in the long run. Now I'm going up in weight a little bit. Again, same amount of sets, just a little bit heavier weight. And at this point, guys, 5 sets of 20 is ridiculous. It's burning. I might not be showing it that much, but trust me, it is burning. So I try to go up one more time, and this is when it started to really show. Now, 315 isn't that heavy necessarily for squatting. At least for me, it isn't. But after doing so many sets, guys, I can only hit this thing twice. I'm not even going to lie to you. Like, I was feeling it, guys. My legs were shaking. I was really feeling it. I could have done more sets, But again, you gotta listen to your body sometimes, guys. There's no point of overtraining yourself, because if you get hurt, then you're backfired so many times. I can tell you plenty of times that I've overtrained myself and it actually slowed down my progress. At this point, guys, I'm doing single leg squats, which is very good. Actually, a lady told me about doing these things. I didn't really like doing it, but you know, I can definitely see the progress of doing it. I can see where it really helps, especially if you're trying to like rebalance your muscles. Like sometimes one side is stronger than the other, or it can take more damage or, you know, more training than the other, if that makes sense. And so guys, definitely incorporate these single leg squats too, man. Like I said, guys, everything I did was 5 sets of 20, so that means I'm not using ridiculously heavy weight. Look at that old guy, man. That man is cut as shit. I'm trying to be like that when I'm old. So, you know, don't use heavy weights if you're trying to do a lot of reps, guys, because the whole purpose of doing high reps is so that you can build up some muscle endurance, man, not so you can build ridiculous amount of muscle. High rep is for strength, and, well, not so much strength. I mean, it is, but it isn't. It's more so for muscle endurance, so you can consistently keep on repping out. Now, shoulders, I'm back in the shoulders again, guys. I'm going to be honest with you. When it comes to shoulders, I don't care what nobody says. I've done my research, and I've also talked to actual fitness doctors. I don't lift nothing heavier than 15 pounds when it comes to shoulders. Why? Because I don't want my rotator cuffs to get torn or messed up. You see a lot of bodybuilders that are like really struggling the shit out of heavy-ass weights. And guys, excuse me for cussing, but when they're older, like in their 50s and 60s, they can't even lift their grandkids up because it's too heavy. The rotator cuffs have been worn out. This exercise right here, I'm not going straight up. I'm going up and out. All right, guys, that was the end of the video. I hope you guys liked it. If you haven't smashed the like button by now, you're just being childish. Anyway, so guys, that was the end of the workout. It was a lot of reps, insane amount of sets. I would recommend that you do it to your own levels. I mean, if you can't do all the sets, you know, make up your own number of sets. You know, I don't judge anybody based on their performance. You know, I judge them based on their, you know, willingness to do as much as they can. Anyway, there's gonna be a lot of voiceovering in the video. So it's hard for me to talk right now, man, because I'm actually really winded. But this is just a regrowth for the legs and shoulders. For anybody, I still recommend this for more so the beginners. But, you know, sometimes you always have to revisit some of the old things, even though you've been working out for years and all that good stuff. So, like I said, guys, hopefully you like this video. Share this video and hit the notification so you can be the first one to see my video and possibly comment if I'm doing something right or wrong, or if you like it or not. With that being said, guys, King Kane, the Fit Pharaoh, stay fit, stay healthy, and always be willing to go forward. King Kane, out. Whoop.